I've been measuring your chocobo's recovery. He's coming along well. He can leap further and higher than before. This means you'll be able to explore more areas of the wildlands. The chocobo can now catch the wind when he jumps. You'll be able to reach more places than you could before. I think if his recovery continues, he'll be able to take you up that cliff and into the Temple of the Goddess.
Thank you.
village of Polta lies in the rocky foothills near the temple. You should talk to the villagers before venturing inside.
You can do.
Thank you.
stretch for miles around. You'll need the help of a chocobo if you want to get anywhere in this terrain. Strange to say, but people have built a village out here. Polta, inhabited by followers of the goddess Etro.
Do this.
Thank you.
you can do.
Thank you.
You can do. Do this. Back to the chaos.
Thank you.
stands a remote village, which is inhabited by followers of Etro. They were run out of the cities for being heretics, and fled here, a land blighted by the goddess's temple, where no others dare to tread.
Do this.
We offer rest for fellow pilgrims. The goddess bless you with good fortune. We have much to offer, though few travelers grace us with their presence out here. I pray the goddess offers you protection throughout your whole journey.
Between the dangerous beasts of the wildlands and the rocky terrain, preparation is key, if you want to stay alive. Find what you need?
You are telling me that his wings are not yet strong enough to bear you to the temple? must wait until he is fully healed, unless...
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome. May I help you? Again, I cannot thank you enough for your assistance.
I always purchase some sheep's milk when I come here.
On behalf of my sheep, I thank you. As promised, I present you with my sheep milk, the likes of which you won't find anywhere else. Just have to milk them. Hang on. There you go. Go on, take it. It's all for you. I tell you, if you hadn't found them, it would have been years of research down the drain.
Okay, so you're a scientist then, not just a sheep farmer?
Yes, exactly. Sheep's milk. That's my specialty. I carefully selected wild specimens and bred them for generations. I fed them a special formula I've refined over the decades, caring for them night and day. At long last, I had the fine, creamy milk I sought. And now I have the inestimable honor presenting the fruit of my labor to you, the one chosen by the Angel of Valhalla.
Chosen by the Angel, huh? So, what makes you think that's me?
Oh, I can put two and two together easily enough. The reports of a white chocobo, the growing tide of chaos and monsters, all are clear signs that the end of the world is upon us. Not only that, amidst all the portents, I hear rumors of a young woman warrior with rose-colored hair, a description that matches that of the white chocobo's master in some of the tales. And just as I was pondering that, you show up. Why, it had to be destiny.
It could be a lot of things. But you believe what you want.
Oh, I will. I have long known that the milk I made here would change the fate of the world. You are the one chosen by the angel. You change the world with every encounter, with every decision. Our meeting here was no accident.
Thank you. You're saying? Mm-hmm.